Are you going on a cruise and wondering what to pack in your shore excursion bag? I have got you covered. In this video, I am going to go over the absolute essentials that you want to bring with you on excursions so that you don't forget a thing. Hi there, I'm Ilana from the website lifewellcruise.com. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. Now in today's video, we are going to talk about all the things that you might need when you get off the ship on those port days. So for those shore excursions, whether it's going to be maybe a catamaran excursion or a beach excursion, or even a shopping or a sightseeing day, we're going to talk about all of that and go through the essentials that you need and all the things that you really just don't want to forget, even if that is on the cruise ship. Now, before I get started, I wanted to mention two things. Firstly, you're not going to need all of these items. So you can take or leave the items that are the most important to you based on the activities that you are doing. However, many of these items are pretty universal and you'll probably need, I'd say, about 2/3 of this list. So make sure you do go through the entire video right up until the end. And secondly, if you do enjoy this video, if you find it helpful, informative, or enjoyable in any way, then please do give the video a big thumbs up. I really do appreciate it. And of course, please subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. Okay, let's get started. So I'm going to share with you four quick tips before we even start to pack your shore excursion bag, just because if you forget these things, it actually could be a problem. So I want you to remember these things. So firstly, it is to bring your government ID or your passport with you when you get off the ship. Now the cruise line is going to let you know if you need to bring your passport off the ship or if a government ID like a driver's license will suffice. Now most of the time when they tell me this, like for instance when I'm in St. Thomas, they say you just need to bring your government ID, and I really just bring my license because I don't want to bring my passport off the ship if I don't need to, especially if I'm going somewhere like a beach. Now the second thing you'll want to bring is some cash and a credit card. Even if you don't plan on using your credit card, you do want to have one credit card with you for emergencies. Now, the third thing you're going to want to bring is any information that the cruise line gives you about the cruise port. Now, oftentimes what cruise lines will give you is sort of a map of the cruise port. So if you get a map, then you can definitely bring that. Now, the important part of this map is going to be over here. You're going to have the information where it's going to tell you who the port agent is and the phone number of that specific cruise port. So that is really meant if you get into a problem, if you need to contact the ship, that is an important phone number. Now, in the case where you have an app and maybe you don't have a paper copy of this map or this information, not a problem, but screenshot this information from the app. And finally, as you leave the ship, take a photo of the all aboard time. So you can either do that as you leave the ship or take a screenshot of the app on that actual day, because sometimes it really does change from your original itinerary. And obviously, there is absolutely nothing worse than getting back to the ship on time to find out that the ship left an hour earlier than you thought. Okay, so now we're ready to pack. So first thing to think about is what you're gonna carry off the cruise ship. So you may wanna carry a backpack, you may wanna carry a big beach bag, you may wanna carry a tote bag. Now, if you're gonna go to the beach or if you're gonna go on a water excursion, then you are gonna wanna have a good sized beach bag. Now, this is a beach bag that I bring just because it's super big and it can carry everything I need. So whether I wanna put in some extra changes of clothes, towels, water bottles, my sunscreen, everything can fit in this beach bag. Oh, and just to mention, all the items that I do show you or talk about in this video will be linked in the description below in case you do want to check them out. Now, I also often bring with me a tote bag. Now, this is a straw tote bag that's lined on the inside. So I've just had this for years. I'm probably due for something new, but that's what I carry with me when I'm going to be maybe shopping around the town. I don't want to bring one of my most expensive tote bags, so I bring something like that, and that's pretty handy. And I've brought it onto some of my catamaran excursions as well. Now, if I do find a new tote bag that I really like, I may just buy it, and I will link that in the description below as well. Number two, remember your sunscreen and remember your lip balm as well, especially if you're on a Caribbean itinerary, a Bermuda itinerary, a Bahamas itinerary, even some of the Mediterranean itineraries. If it is very hot, if it is very sunny, you will get a sunburn if you go without it. Now, something to note is in a lot of the Caribbean islands, they are now asking people to wear reef safe or reef friendly sunscreen. Number three, Don't forget to bring a cover-up. So perhaps you're wearing your bathing suit under your clothes. Make sure you do have a cover-up with you so that you're comfortable. And as well, if you're going to the beach and maybe after the beach, sometimes you might have some time to sightsee or to shop around, then you may even want to change your clothes. If that's the case, bring a change of clothes as well. Number four, you're going to want to wear, of course, some comfortable shoes. And if you're going to the beach or if you're going to do anything that has to do with water, then you want to wear flip-flops. Now, if you're going on an ATV adventure or something like that, then you are going to want to have some sneakers or some closed-toe shoes and probably even some socks. Now, this is something that people actually forget, especially if they are trying to pack light for a cruise, is to bring those shoes that are maybe like a sneaker or something, especially if they don't go to the gym. It's not always obvious. Now, another kind of shoe that can be really handy for you, especially if you're going to the beach or maybe if you're climbing up some waterfalls, for instance, if you're going to Jamaica and you're doing Dunn's River Falls, but is bringing water shoes. Those are really, really good. Even on some of the private islands, you'll find that there are some areas, especially if you're going to be doing some snorkeling, where it is a little bit rocky at the bottom, and those water shoes are really helpful. Number five, a sun hat. Look at that, I'm getting all dressed up for you. So yes, you can bring a sun hat and you can bring a baseball cap when you're going on a cruise. It really is handy when you're walking around the cruise ports or even when you're on the beach. You don't wanna get really too much sun and end up with a bad sunburn when you're on a cruise. Number six, make sure to have some extra sunglasses. Now, this is a true story. My husband brought his good sunglasses with us when we were in Cozumel, Mexico. And for some reason, he put them in his case and then he put them in his side pocket of his shorts. Well, once we got to the beach after the taxi let us off, well, he realized he didn't have his Ray-Ban sunglasses anymore. So a word of advice is bring some inexpensive sunglasses for your shore excursions, especially if you are going to a local beach. It might just be easier if you do lose them. Maybe you go in the water with them. Bring something from Amazon instead. Now, of course, you can bring a water bottle that's disposable if you like, but if you are bringing a refillable water bottle, consider this one. I actually purchased this just about a week ago. A viewer of my channel, let me know if it was you, recommended this Brita water filter. I really like the idea of being able to fill up my water bottle even in the bathroom if I like. And of course, the water is completely drinkable on the cruise ship, but well, sometimes I feel like maybe there's a little bit of a taste to the water in the cabin. Maybe it's my imagination, but I like the idea that I could filter the water. And this one, the filter lasts for, I believe it's like 40 gallons or something like that. But anyway, you don't have to wash the filter. It's fabulous. It lasts for a really long time. And I thought it was so convenient to have it with you on a cruise. Now, these are in no particular order, and I realize I am losing track of my numbers, but I'm still going to go through everything. So this is a waterproof phone case. You'll definitely want to bring this on any water-based excursion. It is so handy, and you can even use it on the cruise ship. So you put your phone in here. It fits my iPhone 12 Pro Max. Fits it perfectly. And you can even, if you want, use it as a little bit of a wallet where you keep a little bit of cash in here if you want, just a little. And you have your key card, your cruise card in it. And that's really perfect for when you do get off the cruise ship. And you can keep it right in your beach bag, your knapsack, or wear it with you around your neck, especially if you are on a ship excursion. Now, another great cruise essential that you could use on the ship and on the beach as well are these towel clips. So super cute, but they'll also hold your towels down in a lot of wind. Now, instead of the towel clips, if you want, you could use towel bands as well. I haven't used the towel bands yet, so please let me know if you have used them or if you use the clips. What do you prefer? Please let me know down in the comments below. Now, if you're going on an excursion that might be in a rainforest, or maybe you're going to see the ruins or something, like sometimes in Mexico, you can go see those Mayan ruins. Make sure that you do bring some bug spray with you. That is very important. You do not want to get eaten up by mosquitoes. Now, if you're going on a cruise with kids, I have a tip for you that you are going to love. Make sure to bring some sand toys with you so that when you do go to the beach, your kids have their sand toys. There are some that are actually kind of collapsible sand toys, so they don't even take a lot of room, and you can put them either in your beach bag or you can bring like a mesh beach bag with you so you don't get sand all over your other items. Now, the simplest item ever, but really it's so handy, is bring some Ziplocs with you on your excursion, but bring them with you on your cruise as well. Whether you want to put your wet bathing suit into a big Ziploc, or if you want to bring maybe some dry snacks from the cruise ship, make sure that you don't bring any fruit or meats, by the way, off the cruise ship, because you definitely can't do that and it can get you in trouble and you could even get a fine. So definitely don't do that. But most of the islands will allow you to bring some dry snacks off the cruise ship. So if you do want to bring like a pastry or a croissant, you can oftentimes do that. Do keep an eye on whatever information you get from the cruise line, because if they tell you not to do it, then definitely don't do it. Now, if you want to be a little bit fancy, you could bring a dry bag with you and you can put your bathing suit in that. Or if you are going on an excursion where you're going, let's say, into a kayak, that might be the time that you do want that proper dry bag or that proper waterproof backpack. Now, if you like all of these tips and packing lists, I do have an entire cruise planner that is full of 47 pages of cruise packing lists, what you need for your shore excursions, and really much more, even including how to plan your shore excursions for every single port. Now, if you are interested in checking that out, I will also leave the information for that in the description below. I can't remember if I mentioned this, but I don't think I did. It is that if you are going on any water type excursion, sometimes what's really handy is to bring some sea bands or some Bonine with you, or maybe even take it beforehand. I have friends that did a whale watching excursion on a Canada New England cruise, and unfortunately it was very rocky, and well, my friend's husband got quite ill, and she said in hindsight they really should have worn the sea bands that they left back on the cruise ship. Now, even though in this video I've talked about the days that are sunny and being prepared for that, there are days where maybe the weather isn't so nice and maybe there's some drizzle or some rain. So I do like to bring an umbrella with me. I bring a small compact travel umbrella. You just never know. And I would hate to miss out on a day where I have something planned just because of a little bit of rain. And otherwise, bring maybe a poncho, something very thin. That could be handy as well, especially if the weather is still quite warm and you just want to get that rain off your head. So of course, we all want to bring some hand sanitizer with us or some disinfectant wipes. I really like these bottles because you can have several of them and just clip them right onto your backpack. They're super handy and you can refill them as well. Now, if you are going off on your own to a local beach, or maybe you're going to the private island, consider bringing your own snorkel equipment. If you get your own mask, it's so much cheaper than doing an excursion and it's probably a lot cleaner as well. Now, you may want to bring binoculars as well. Now, this is especially the case if you are on an Alaskan cruise, a Canada New England cruise, where you may see whales and other marine life, but it can be the case even when you're in the Caribbean. And of course, you'll make great use of these on the cruise ship as well. Now, two more things to bring on your cruise that are just really super practical. Ladies, girls, make sure that you bring your hair elastics. I always have a little package of hair elastics and some clips whenever I'm on a cruise. You just never know when you want to put your hair up. And I always think one of the most important things is be prepared with a few band-aids and some polysporin or some antibiotic ointment. You never even know when you get a blister on your foot or a little cut or something. You want to disinfect that right away. And of course, you want to have a band-aid. Now, I'd love to know what you think and what you bring on an excursion. Is there anything that I didn't think of? Please let me know in the comments below, because I know it will also help other people as well. Now, I will leave that ultimate cruise planner. I am going to leave the information for you linked in the description below. It is 47 pages and it is $10 off right now. Now, I am going to leave a video right after this one all about the cruise hacks that you can use to absolutely transform the space in your cruise cabin. Now, I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, please do give it a big thumbs up. I really do appreciate it. And of course, please subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. Bye for now, and happy cruising.